From big ball gowns and bold colors to capes and baby bumps, the stars sizzled on the red carpet last night. Mm-hmm. But sadly, a few of them also fizzled.
Yeah, that's right. And here to break down who got it right and who got it oh so wrong is celebrity stylist Phillip Block, as well as the star of Bravo's hit series Fashion Queens, Bevy Smith. Hey.
Okay, Lupita Nyong'o.
Yes. Mm-hmm. First of all, I love the way you say Lupita Nyong'o. I think I might have locked in because of the way you just pronounced it.
I thought she was muy caliente Lauren dress and cape. What did you all think?
I mean, she was perfect and divine in every way.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
The color, the fact that she is a dark-skinned woman with natural hair on the red carpet. We saw a bit of that when
Viola Davis
did it towards the tail end of her Oscar campaign. Right. Remember when she popped out in the orange and she had the natural hair? So that was a very exciting moment. But to see it from a young woman who's clearly gonna have a long career ahead of herself.
Well, she's
really
been
exciting.
Killing it on the red carpet, too. Mm-hmm. She's really, and people keep comparing it to the Gwyneth Tom Ford dress, but this was a whole nother level.
Yes.
What is it she keeps doing right? Because she seems to always get it right.
Everything, just so chic and elegant, simple.
Yeah, and also too, I think that she has a really great innate sense of style. Mm-hmm. Normally when it's their first foray into the red carpet moment, they get a lot of things wrong.
Because it's very difficult.
Those stylists set them astray.
Her stylist is Michaela Erlanger, and she's not afraid to put her in color, and she realizes that color against that flawless dark skin also really works for her. Wouldn't you guys agree?
Yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm.
And she's a small girl and the dresses don't overpower her, which Fairy does sometimes.
Good. All right. Well, speaking of overwhelming.
Yes, Jennifer Lawrence. I mean, she won the Globe for Best Supporting Actress, but people on social media panned her look. Yeah. I mean, what do you think in this Dior? Is it a winning look for her?
I think that, you know, she is a spokeswoman for Dior, and the fact that she couldn't find something a little more age appropriate, one, and two, a little more exciting and full of more pizzazz was really shocking to me. It feels like she didn't really want to do too much, and she just said, give me a dress, make sure it's Dior, and let me just go.
Okay. That dress was doing way too many things. Like, you never do that on the waist and then at the hip. It always...
Mm-hmm. It always does something wrong.
It looks like it's a trash bag.
Oh, did you see some of the spoofs that people had on social media? They had like Ariel, the mermaid. Look at this.
Oh, making fun of her dress. Some guy in a trash bag.
Right.
It looked kind of like a trash bag.
Yeah, and then someone also said it looked like the old timey barkeeps. What they used to put on their arms.
It was by Pirate Wenchy as well. I thought it looked like a comforter.
But it wasn't very comforting to us,
but it was very comfortable to her. And I really do think that she was probably going for comfort. You know, at the Golden Globes, you get to drink, copious amounts of free champagne and vodka. You notice everyone kept mentioning the vodka and the drinking.
Yes.
So maybe she wanted to be careful, comfortable, and wanted to, really just get turned up.
Let me just say something. She's too pale for that white of a dress. The dress was too white. She's too pale. The blonde hair, it's very washed out other than the black straps.
Huh. All right, Emma Stone and Chanel. Was she too understated for the evening?
This is how you feel about the outfit? Is that how you feel? You can't even sit up straight about it. Tell us how you really feel, Phillip.
I wish I could go down for you.
Tell us how you really feel. Good. What do you think, baby?
I mean, Emma Thompson. I mean, what did you think?
Let's see the photo.
Let's see the photo, please.
Emma Thompson, that dress just didn't fit. It was ridiculous.
Let's see the Emma Thompson photos, please. Yes.
There we go, the three E's. Okay, so what do you think about this?
Well, which one is Emma Thompson?
Emma Thompson.
We have Emma Thompson, we have Emma Stone, and we have Emma Roberts.
Oh, yes.
Emma Thompson, disaster. Emma Stone, and...
Emma Roberts.
Emma Roberts
is lovely.
Yeah. Amazing.
Emma Thompson, I said that she had that high water dress. She was expecting a flood. It was a weird length. And then and then when she got on stage, she had the cocktail in her hand and the Louboutins and threw them away. It was a weird moment.
It was a weird moment.
It was that champagne that we keep referring to.
She brought her martini up on stage. And clearly it was shaken, stirred, dirty, clean. She had a little bit of everything.
What was that?
I don't quite get it.
Yeah. I just didn't get it. And she's having a moment, so that shouldn't have been the dress for the moment. No. Look at that mess.
Let's move on then. Yeah. Let's go to Amy Adams. Because Amy Adams had a good night.
Amy Adams, to me, she is my new go-to fashionista agenda.
Really?
She is usurping Julianne Moore for me. Oh. I'm putting my money on this red firecracker ginger gal. I thought she looked gorgeous. I loved it when she had on the cape. I think she saw Lupita and said, well, I can't compete with Lupita, so I'm going to take off that cape. But I thought that the dress was beautiful and very reminiscent to her wardrobe in American Hustle.
Absolutely. Very American Definitely. Hustle. She's giving you that 70s, 80s cleavage there, boy. Woo.
And again, you know, I'm obsessed with women with small enough cleavage, so we are plunging neckline, because that's something I could never do, unless I wanted to be in another
wardrobe
kind of
malfunction.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, Sofia Vergara, she took a fashion risk. She's usually in her mermaid silhouette,
dress,
right? Mm-hmm. But she decided that she was going to come in a giant, full Zac Posen ball gown. She even joked about smuggling a whole bunch of Colombians in under her dress.
Exactly. And she could have.
And she could have. What did you make of this
dress?
Look?
I thought
the dress,
dress
and
is
then
a
the necklace.
Very, mm-hmm. You know, I'm going to get all of it. I thought that the dress was really pretty, really flattering on her, except the color. Like black, no ma'am.
No,
it was
ma'am.
Just too drab. It didn't do anything for her complexion. It just wasn't a pop. And then, of course, I think that she gave a salute to the pop of color with the turquoise necklace. I'm a huge fan of Lorraine Swartz jewelry. I hope one day to be able to wear some of it.
We can borrow some for you, girl.
We can definitely borrow some. Well, I know Lorraine, too, so I mean, I'm sure she would lend me some, but, you know, all in due time.
I don't know
but
her.
I thought I'm willing to
make a hookup.
Yeah. But I thought that the turquoise still didn't give the dress enough oomph.
And it was too much. The necklace was almost too big because she's got quite a body.
It's turquoise, but you know, when you think of turquoise, you think of daytime.
Yeah.
Yes. You don't think of night.
I don't.
Yeah, well, that was not a daytime necklace.
I think of Arizona. I think of Texas.
Well, she took it to another level, but it was a lot. It wasn't one of my favorites.
Okay.
But I loved that she tried something different. Thank God she wasn't in a Zuhair Mourad mermaid dress again. Thank you.
All right, so Julia Louis Dreyfus, she definitely showed the young girl she still got the stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She's got a rocking little body. I love this, really bold, vibrant red.
Yes. And that's Narciso Rodriguez.
Yeah, Narciso Rodriguez.
Well,
I love the sweetheart
neckline,
the halter moment. I thought it was really chic.
Yeah, that kind of 50s Balanchino kind of moment. And they work together a lot, so he gets her body, he knows how to design for her. You can always see when a designer works with the celebrity a lot, like Amy Adams and Caroline Herr, you can tell when the designer knows their body and they create something special for them.
So okay. True. Diane Keaton.
Okay, Diane Keaton. I love it from the ruler to the tutor.
Okay.
The Murphy Brown hair, the Candace Bergen Murphy Brown hair, and then the suit, which looks like she pulled it from the Great Gatsby, the Robert Redford.
Annie Hall.
No. Not Annie Hall, because Annie Hall was slouchy. This is a fitted, tailored nip suit. Mm. I loved it. I thought it was gorgeous, and I loved the wide tie. Again, very Ralph Lauren. That Ralph Lauren started out as a tie
designer. Yeah.
And that's how his ties were.
I
just thought it was amazing on her. So chic.
I love that look.
And you know, we also saw this look earlier in the season on Lauren Hutton.
Absolutely.
That's true.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think this is a great look for women of a certain age
that have a certain
look
body type.
Exactly, exactly.
Okay. And that's her signature.
Yes, absolutely.
And
she's done this look over and over and over again, and it never gets old.
But the hair was sexy.
Yes.
And I love the addition of the Martin Scorsese glasses.
There you go.
Yes.
Well, she was there to honor him and receive his award.
Woody Allen.
Sorry, Martin Scorsese.
Well, he's got funny little guests.
Yeah, exactly.
Kate Blanchett.
This is the dress for me.
This was it?
I loved it. I loved Armani Privé. Hi, Kate. Mm-hmm. She's waving to us.
She just did that to us.
Yeah. Love her. She's flawless. She never gets it wrong. Flawless, absolutely. And it's interesting because we've seen this similar dresses to this in the past year. Kristen wore it for the Twilight premiere. Charlize Theron wore something very similar, but this one, the back was exquisite.
The back was exquisite. You didn't even need the back, but then when you got the back, it was a happy bonus, you know what I mean?
Right.
But I thought that she really showed the young girls how to really work a red carpet. She looked divine and gorgeous. And also, too, the fact that she went to Mr. Armani, you know, who actually really created the whole red carpet dressing phenom, I just thought, you know, take it right back to the classic, take it back to the master.
Well, and she's someone who always goes for like the McQueens or the, you know, someone more edgy, a Gaultier or something. So for her to do Armani and make it look new and fresh and sexy modern, and modern and yet elegant and classic was perfect.